Hello, good afternoon, respected all. My name is Deepak Kumar Maheda. Today I am going to present the topic systematic review on screening methods available for nicotine and their metabolites in forensic toxicology. Papers which are published during year 2000 to 2021 are taken into consideration. The tobacco plant belongs to Solanaceae family, and it is originally a native plant of America, but it is now cultivated on a large scale in India. The dried leaves are used in India in the form of snuff for a chew with lime and pan. Tobacco leaves contains 0.5 to 8% of nicotine, which is lipid soluble and highly toxic alcohol. Mostly it is used as a stimulant, but also used as pesticides. Low doses of nicotine stimulate the neural and cardiovascular systems, and high doses produce depressive effects. Oral absorption of nicotine forms 49 by oxidation via the enzyme cytochrome P450, and it produces trans 3-dash hydroxycotinate. 30 to 60 milligram of nicotine proven to be fatal in adult, and 10 milligram in children. So there are mainly, and if you talk about metabolites, there are mainly two metabolites are considered in the sense of forensic toxicology. One is 49, and other one is trans 3-dash hydroxycotinate. Both are highly toxic for humans and animals. In these studies, various biosamples are used, such as blood, urine, brain tissue, kidney tissue, lung tissue, and hair. From these all biosamples, hair is most precise for nicotine extraction, because hair preserves nicotine for a long term. Also, determination in mummified bodies can be possible by using hair samples. The preparation of sample is most important prior to the detection. There are many extract techniques available for nicotine and their metabolites extraction, such as liquid-liquid extraction, solid-phase extraction, ultrasonic extraction, and maceration extraction. From these all techniques, ultrasonic extraction has more approximate extraction recovery rate, but it is rarely used. And maceration technique is conducted at room temperature. It consists of immersing plant in a liquid such as water or alcohol inside an airtight container for variable times. Now we come to the detection procedure. There are many classical and instrumental techniques are used for detection of nicotine and their metabolites. Immune assay procedures, radio immune assay and enzymatic immune assay. Both are used for primary detection of nicotine and 49. LC-MS provides great selectivity, accuracy, precision, and high sensation analysis of nicotine and 49 in the hair of mummified body can also be possible. SPLC is separately used in some studies. GC-MS can be used for confirmatory test of nicotine and 49. And TLC procedures, nicotine and its metabolite can be detected by TLC, but it cannot identify the metabolite. So it is used very rarely. Okay, thank you, sir.